two different different values, you will get different different flip flop. If the value is one, then you will get only one flip flop. Just take this example. Okay, let I am writing Q1 equal to D. After that, Q3 equal to Q2. After that, Q2 equal to Q1. Let the initial values of D is equal to 4 and Q1 is equal to 5. Q2 is equal to 6. Okay, no, I'll just take one values. Okay, see, actually here only one values will be taken because I am considering 1-bit flip flop. But just for your understanding, I am taking some integer values. Because if it is an integer, means it will be more than 1-bit. So more than 1-bit means more flip flop will get generated. Here actually it is 1-bit. This Q1, D, Q3, Q2 all are of 1-bit. Just for your understanding, okay, let's just take, let its value equal to A. Q1 value equal to B, Q2 value is equal to C, and Q3 equal to D. So now here Q1 will be equal to, okay, not D, let E. Now Q1 is equal to D. So what will be Q1 value?
A.
Now Q3 is equal to Q2. So what will be Q3 value?
C.
Now Q2 equal to Q1, right?
Yes.
So what will be Q2 value? So simple, just like this. Okay. So now for this and this only one values are stored. As it is a blocking assignment, it is going to take this and this as only one flip flop. Okay. One flip flop, simple input will be D, output will be Q2. And another flip flop to store this one. So in the blocking assignment, the order of execution matters. So if I'm just changing the order of execution, then synthesis value output will get changed. But if it is a non-blocking, then 3 means 3. In which manner you write, it will generate only 3 flip-flops. Okay, just this kind of questions they may ask you. So just give a look. Okay, so how these things are written. Okay.
Ma'am, in the same PDF, can you go to question 46?
Question 46. Right?
46, yes.
Okay.
Ma'am, what will the answer for 38? It should be 3, right?
No, it's 38. Okay. 38. Okay, let's check. What is 38? Q1 is equal to D, Q2 is equal to Q1. Okay. So you only tell me, okay, Q1 equal to D.
Okay, Q3 ma'am, I got it. To... All will get the same value.
Yeah, so only one flip flop. Okay.
Okay.
Now 46. Okay. Up to 43, 44. Yeah. So which of the following statement declares 2D array of 2K rows and 1K column, where every array element can store an octal digit? Okay. So anyone have done this thing? Hello.
No, ma'am, I didn't know how to do this. I took a guess.
Would be, ma'am, it would be B or D.
Okay. I guess just looking into here, you are guessing it may be B or D, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So first of all, okay.
The answer is actually the answer is not correct because every array element can store an octal digit. So maybe B is the correct answer because octal digit needs 3 bits.
See, actually what she said, as octal digit can be stored, so she is just guessing it may be B or C. Yes. Okay, so now see, just here, okay, first of all, every array element can store octal digit. So it is like, just 1 minute. This is some row, and there will be some column like this. So now here one value stored, here one value stored, here one value, here one value, here one value. So according to question, whatever the value stored here, that is an octal. Octal means it is a 3-bit value, 0 to 7. Okay, so first I have to check how many arrays I have among them which array can store octal. So if I am simple writing reach 4 down to 0, so then variable name, let variable 1. So whatever I am writing before the variable name, that is the individual value size. So here it is given octal. Octal means it can be only 2 down to 0. If it is this kind of things, then that array can store the octal values. So this array can store only one octal values. What I need, it will be storing octal values. How many octal values? Rows are 2k, columns are 1k. So first I have to mention the row, then I have to mention the column. That is after the variable name. So rows is 2k. So rows equal to 2k. 2k means it is like 1024 into 2. That is almost 2048. So row size will be 2048. I can write 2047 down to 0. Now row size becomes 2048. Next comes column. So column equal to 1k. So 1k means it is like 1024. So I have to give the column size, that will be like 1023 down to 0. Understood? So here I guess what is the answer then? Yeah, B is the answer.
And ma'am, like I couldn't understand the second assignment, like all the 5 questions, ma'am. I couldn't design any, like not this as a very long assignment to PDF.
Okay, that is like, okay. Just wait. Okay, yeah. I'll be going to that also. Okay.
Yes,
that is a coding question, right?
Yes, ma'am. All were designed and verification
questions. Okay. I will.